I want to talk about the word rejection. That is an ugly word. Nobody likes that word, whether it's feeling rejected in a relationship or a job pursuit. Satan tries to play that trick on us, doesn't he? That somehow we're too far removed from God's grace. Whatever kind of rejection you might relate to, one thing I know is that we will all drink from that cup of rejection. We'll all taste that, and we won't like the taste. I think about Joseph in the Bible, and man, if there was a guy who was rejected in the Bible, that guy had been, completely betrayed by his family, right? One thing that sticks out to me when I read the story of Joseph, though, is that several times in Scripture you read these words, "The Lord was with Joseph." And I think that's really profound, isn't it? That in the midst of Joseph being rejected by his family, sold by his brothers, the Lord was with Joseph. Maybe you could take encouragement from that today, just being reminded that whatever rejection you've faced in your life, guess who is still with you in the middle of that rejection? The Lord was with Joseph, and the Lord is with you. And that rejection, if you remember the story of Joseph, it looked like rejection, but it was really preparation for something greater. And you look at the great things that God did through Joseph, and it began with that story of rejection. So not only can you face your season of rejection knowing that the Lord is with you, but you can also face that season of rejection and let it turn into a spirit of anticipation to say, okay, Lord, I see this door closing. I'm getting ready for a bigger door to open because I know that my God is with me and I know that he's in control and he's working on a greater level than I can even imagine. So you can look that rejection in the eye today and look at it with anticipation to see what God's gonna do and how he's gonna bring you through.